The two tools that people are talking the most about right now are Lovable and Base44. Lovable just raised $200 million at a $1.8 billion valuation, and Base44 just sold for $80 million to Wix. These tools are worth a lot of money, but are they actually any good? Let's dive in. First, we're going to start with Lovable, and then I'm going to compare it to Base44 in the video in just a minute. Right off the bat, Lovable has a brand new feature called Lovable Agent. This is promising better results, has capabilities like web search and image generation, and has a new pricing model. What's nice about this new pricing model on Lovable is you're going to start to pay based on the value or difficulty of the task that you're giving the AI. So just as an example, if you just want to change a button color, it's only going to cost half a credit. If you want to build a whole landing page with images, it's going to cost 1.7 credits. So it's going to charge you more based on work done. This is different than Base44, which we're going to get into in a second. So the prompt that I'm going to give both tools is a simple prompt to build me a personal finance AI coach that gives advice to me on my finances. I'm going to send this prompt on Lovable first, and I'm going to talk a little bit about what's happening here with Lovable. So on the left side, we have our dashboard, basically our chat, where it's going to think about what it's going to build and tell us what it's going to do. You can also on the bottom actually ask Lovable to make changes and continue to improve your app and go back and forth. On the right side, we have our preview where you're going to be able to see the app live. Now, this is very similar to Base44, which I'm going to show you right now. So we're going to go ahead and give it the exact same prompt. One difference right off the bat that I'm going to show you here with Base44 is you can add style instructions if you want to give it style instructions without you having to think about how to describe this. This is something really nice that I wish Lovable would add as well, but because I want a head-to-head comparison, I'm just going to give it the exact same prompt for now. So I'm going to send this off, and this, of course, looks very similar to Lovable. On the left side, we have our chat, and on the right side, we have our preview. So for both of these, it's going to just take a few minutes to actually get our initial design, and then future changes are going to be done more quickly. Something else that I really like about Base44 is I just like the design of its checklist here of telling us what it's doing in real time. So while they're building the initial first versions of these apps, what I want to do is talk about some of the differences between Lovable and Base44. So with Base44, the database and backend is all integrated directly into Base44. It's all in one platform. You don't have to worry about connecting to any other services. You have it all in one. And this is both a pro and a con. It depends on what you want out of a platform. For people who are less technical and just want everything all in one, this is a real positive. For people who want more control and want a separate database, which also gives you the ability to more easily leave the platform in the future, Lovable is going to give you that separate database. They integrate with Supabase by default. So here we are in Lovable. We can see right on the top, there's a Supabase integration. You just click Connect Supabase, and then it all connects and adds your backend. So it's very easy to do that with Supabase and Lovable. They make it easy, but it is a little bit just easier and all-in-one in Base44. Okay, we have our initial draft of our app that we built here with Lovable. So here we are in Lovable. It has a really nice dashboard here, our AI personal finance coach, insights, check-in. This is really quite good for a first draft that it created. So this is Lovable. Now, for the first draft here in Lovable, it looks like it basically made a dashboard, and otherwise it's not functional at all. None of this is really going to work. I think all of this is just basically templated questions. I'm getting the same result. There's definitely a lot more work that would need to be done. We'd also have to integrate with like OpenAI, for example, to actually have the AI finance coach work. But off the bat, this is a pretty good result. couple other features that we have here on the left side. We have edit, so we can go in and directly edit anything on the page. This is lovable. So if I click here, I can ask for quick changes. We can also edit the content directly by clicking this. Sometimes it doesn't let you do it, but sometimes it does. So this is saying the content is linked to the back end or code, as opposed to front end, which this is probably going to let me do it. No, that as well. So it's asking me to ask for quick changes here. Sometimes it lets you just change the text directly. So it just depends on what you're doing. You can also edit the style just like a no code builder, which is pretty cool. So you can just change it here. You can change the font weight, color, and more advanced things as well. So here we are in Base44 with the first draft that it created. So here it looks like it just created the dashboard. It didn't also create that like landing page area above. I always think it's just interesting to give the exact same prompt to two different AI builders and see what they come up with and how it compares just on the first basically go of it. So here, if we go down, basically has this ability to get AI advice. If I click that, it seems to be generating, but I'm not sure if anything is going to happen. But it did seem to create these AI recommendations. So maybe it did. If I mark this as red, it's just going to remove that button of mark as red, which is interesting. Under profile setup, it basically is allowing me to enter basic financial information. And then on the homepage, I can update the profile. Let's see if this works. So let's just change monthly income to, just curious, $20. If I go down, click update profile. Now it looks like it did update it here automatically. So this is the magic of having the backend basically database integrated with Base44 all in one. With Lovable, we're going to have to go another step and actually integrate with Superbase to make this work. But here it's just updated automatically and it's all working with the database. If we go to the workspace here on the top left in Base44, if we go to data, we can see the data models were created. So financial profile and even AI advice seems to be actually created right off the bat. So these two tables were all created. There's also analytics built in. You can connect your domain, which you can also do with Lovable. So that's not different. Security, this is built in. This is similar to what Superbase has, but it's just all in one again with Base44. You can view the actual code there. Under API, you can see the APIs that were basically written. And then under users, you can see all of the users that are in the app. So I'm actually pretty impressed with what Base44 is able to do right off the bat. Let me talk about some of the other similarities and differences between Base44 without just spending a lot of time tinkering, because you can go in and actually go back and forth with the chat. But I want to talk about some of the other similarities and differences. So I already talked a little bit about the pricing of Lovable, which now is charging based on the type of task that's done. So the pricing for Base44 is a little bit different, and this also reflects the different capabilities that Base44 has. So here on Base44, for example, for the $20 a month plan, you get 100 messages per month and 2,000 integration credits per month. The message credits is talking about you building, so basically going back and forth with the editor. So this is what Lovable just changed. Lovable used to do it by messages. Now they're doing it based on the type of message. Maybe Base44 will go in that direction. Right now it's just based on messages. Integration credits are based on the usage of your app. Because Base44 integrates here, and we can see they integrate with things like LLMs, which are giving you AI chat, file uploading, image understanding, image generation, send email sending, SMS sending, etc. So it has these functionalities built in. You're going to have to pay for that. Whereas with a tool like Lovable, you're going to just connect directly to tools like OpenAI or things like that, or Twilio for SMS. So that's the main difference. So again, it all goes back to Base44 being the all-in-one platform, Lovable being the more extendable platform. Real quick, another similarity here with Base44 and Lovable is you have the same visual edit here where you can visually click on things, change the text, the colors, etc. on Base44. The same discuss feature, this is a way to basically chat with AI before actually building out a feature, which can get you a better result sometimes. Lovable has the exact same feature. Here we can change the model. Similar, this is actually something that Lovable gives you less control over. So in Lovable, you don't have the ability to change the model that's being used. You just have to use what Lovable gives you. With Base44, we get to choose Sonnet 4 or 2.5 Pro, or you can let it choose the best for you automatically. Under AI controls, you can give custom instructions. You can do the same exact thing with Lovable. And similarly, you can freeze files. This is if you know that a file is done in really good shape, you don't want the AI to make changes to it, you can freeze the file. You can do the same thing in Lovable as well. So just to show you this AI integrated functionality, what I'm going to do is say, please build me a chat page where I can chat with an AI financial advisor. So what I want to do is demonstrate here the integrated LLM functionality. And let's do the exact same thing in Lovable just to show you the difference here. So it's going to build out here in Lovable, and we're going to see the difference is Lovable is not going to have the AI functionality off the bat. We would have to connect Supabase and ask it to connect to OpenAI. Again, this is not too difficult of a thing to do. I have lots of videos on how to do it, as well as an in-depth course, which you can check in the description on how to build with Lovable and also more advanced tools like Cursor. But this is a key difference between the platforms. So something that I want to highlight here. So here we are on the AI chat feature that Base44 built. So let me just ask a question. So I'll say, what is a 401k? So I'm going to send that message. And we got a real response from an AI. And I didn't have to worry about integrating with OpenAI or anything like that. And if we go into our workspace and we go to the logs, for example, we can see invoke LLM was created for us. So the input and the output. So this was all done for us without having to build it ourselves. Now, this gives us less control. I don't know what model was used. I don't know how much it costs. I don't, other than the cost that Base44 is going to charge me. So there's pros and cons with both. Honestly, for a lot of cases, I would prefer to build it out with Lovable and have more control. But I am really comfortable with building with these AI and no code tools. Whereas for someone who is less technical and just doesn't have as much experience doing it, just wants to get started, this is really amazing. And I think for a lot of people, I would recommend using Base44 for that reason. The fact that all integrated, I didn't even have to think about it, is pretty amazing. So here in Lovable, it's saying basically the chat is built, it's over here. I think it looks really good, but again, there's no actual AI. This is just basically done with hard-coded in questions. So then I sent the same message, what is a 401k? And it's just getting basically this canned response. Again, this could easily be changed by connecting to Supabase. We can also connect to GitHub here with Lovable. Sync all of our code, which is really nice. There's also just nice team features built in with Lovable that make it really easy to build with. So I hope that you enjoyed this quick comparison between Lovable and Base44. As a quick recap, Lovable is going to give you more control over what you're building. It's going to be able to have your own external database that you can use with any coding tool that you want. Whereas Base44 is more of an all-in-one platform. Think of it a little bit more like Squarespace or Wix. Wix is the company that purchased them, so it all makes sense. But think of it like that. It's going to be for someone who's less technical and just wants everything to work out of the box. Be sure to subscribe to our channel to get more free content just like this. And if you have any questions at all, please just leave a comment below. We'll see you in the next video.